All right, so I was just in bed and just could not go to sleep. So I was like, let's make a video right now. I was gonna make one when I woke up from a nap. But I'm half tired, half asleep. Half asleep sounds more accurate. And for some reason, I was like, you know what? Ski-Doo Snowmobile Challenge sounds like a great idea. So I just read the instruction booklet just to kind of have an idea of how to play this. And we're gonna do a few races really quick. This is, I don't know if this is budget or not. I'm not sure if this is like a budget title. But I do know this came out, what year? 2008 on the PS3, and I'm gonna assume probably the 360, maybe the Wii. Let me double check that, 'cause we have quite the wait here. Anyways, let me see. What did this come out on? It's also very quiet. Yep, PS3, Xbox 360, and Wii. It's a very quiet game. There we go. There's audio. I was gonna say this is like a very awkwardly quiet game, but it's a snowmobile game, which is interesting to me because I don't know if I've ever played a snowmobile game. I know there's like some stunting, there's a boost in it. It sounds very, very basic though, so we're just gonna go in single race, see what we got. Oh dear. So you gotta go through a loading process every time you want to select a different sled. Holy. And you gotta go through career mode to get all these. All right, so we're gonna use the basic bitch one. Fuck it. Let's just go basic. Screw it. Okay, so we got a bunch of different tracks. Ooh. Let's go Canada first. Why not? But yeah, we're gonna see if this is any good. The loading times right now are not very promising to me at all. But whatever. Let's do cross country Canada. And just see what we got, because I think the entire prospect of a snowmobile game is cool to me. Like I've done like racing in skis, I've done racing in snowboards, you know, stuff like that. But snowmobile, that's new to me. But we got a little bit of a stunt system, as loading screen says. I guess like when you go in the air, you can jump up, press a button, and then do like another button combination to do stunts. I'm going to assume that probably ties directly into the boost system. Maybe. I'm not sure like what the purpose of it is, but I guess we'll find out. Maybe it's just fun. I'm cool with it being just fun. But yeah, I don't have like super high hopes for this, but I'm really, you know, just in my heart of hearts hoping this is okay. The loading screens are already kind of disgusting me though. So we're gonna find out. Let's see. All right, so we already got a crazy bit of blur. Oh, that adrenaline meter to the right, that like beating heart, I don't like that. That just looks weird. I get what they're going for with it. I already don't like it though. All right, so we can crash, we can fall off, we gotta reset a bit. The controls are very loose. Very, very loose. Like you go sliding very fast here. Okay. Yep, and if you do a stunt, you get some adrenaline. I guess if you crash into people, you get some adrenaline too. Okay. I'm cool with the music though, and I think visually, like, I guess the snow looks okay for what it is for like a 2008 PS3 game. I'm not like particularly impressed though. That stunt system's awkward too. Very awkward. Very awkward. So I guess I gotta get like super air to make that work. I'm very far behind now. Let's stop going for a stun here. It's not gonna work. Okay. Let's see how the rubber banding is. Let's see like if they rubber band like the AI closer to me maybe, so I can play like a catch-up game. Who knows? Maybe. I'm not gonna say it controls bad though. I've just never did a snowmobile game before, so I don't know if this would be like accurate to like how a snowmobile would feel. I'm not sure. I've never driven one. Whereas like I've driven cars and I've, you know, been on bikes kind of before. Not super fast, but I know like how those should somewhat feel, but I'm not sure if this is like accurate to like what a snowmobile would feel like. Maybe. I can see it being like very slidey and like very like loosey-goosey like this. It's just very touchy. as you can probably see, because I'm barely, like, you can probably hear it over the mic, like, me tapping the analog stick. I'm not, like, going hard into these turns. Like, I'm going very, very easy with them and, like, just slowly correcting myself. But, yeah, no, they're pretty brutal. Okay. Still trying to catch up here. I'm gonna get there, though. Oh, I could have totally done a stunt. I just don't want to, like, do a stunt, like, while I'm still trying to catch up, though. Just in case. The stunts are how I ended up so far behind anyways. I think it was actually this one, yeah. But we're caught back up, so that's good. So I'm assuming they must rubber band the AI a bit. Because rubber banding, I think, goes both ways. Like, you have, like, your traditional rubber banding AI, like, where the AI is always on your ass during a race to kind of make it feel like you can still slip down to number two at any time. And then I guess they might slow down the AI a bit to give you a chance to catch back up if you get disastrously behind like I did there. Because this game's obviously very arcadey. Like, it's not, like, trying to, like, hide that, you know? Which is cool. I'm fine with that. Also, keep in mind as I play this, I am half asleep trying to do this. So my reaction times and, like, you know, my critical thinking at the moment, especially in terms of racing on snow, not quite there. It is not. But yeah, no, this is a very... It's not bad. So far, it's not terrible. I just, like, don't have, like, the proper speeds or, like, anything. It's interesting, though. It is very, very interesting, this game. I think next race I'll do a lot better. Now that I kind of, like, know what to expect. This one, I'm just desperately trying to go way too fast to catch back up, and it's screwing me over. Races are nice and long, though, like, nice and lengthy. And this is, like, one of the only, like, early PS3 games I look at the back of the box on. And I look at, like, the online advertisement, and I don't see, like, a GameSpy advertisement. So that gives me, like, a little suspicion that maybe, just maybe, there's hope I could actually connect to the servers. I doubt it. But, like, almost all, like, the old PS3 games, like, have, like, online done by GameSpy, which means you're not going to get stuff anymore. GameSpy is long gone. But this one isn't, so maybe, like, maybe, just maybe, like, there might be a central server still. I mean, granted, this game's, like, 12 years old. Hey, look, a trophy. A silver one, for that matter. Yowie wowie. Oh, two trophies. Oh, look, this is the best game. It's rewarding me for being, like, last place an entire race. Damn. This is tough, man. But yeah, I wonder if, like, the server's, like, I wonder if I could, like, still connect. It's so tough. Like, I'm sure I could get the feel for this after a bit. It's just, this is so... It's tricky. Okay, well, this should be the end of the race here. Yep. Alright, so disastrous first attempt. And the game takes over, just crashes into people like a dick. Okay. Also, admittedly, I'm also on the starter ski-mobile. Ski-mobile? Snowmobile. There we go. So maybe it's just, like, that one doesn't control well. Like, if you look at the stats, like, on single race, like, they're all, like, 1 out of 10. Like, or, like, 1 out of 20, like, whatever the base system on this is. So. Could just be that. Oh, no, no, not the same map. The loading screen went so fast, I was just mashing X. I did this to myself. Maybe it's a different track. These loading screens, though. This is what's gonna kill the game to me. It's been so long. I'm playing for 10 minutes. I'm pretty sure 3 minutes have been loading screen so far. It's absurd. If any game could have like benefited maybe from like doing like an install, it would be this one, I think. But no, this might be a, no, this is a different course, so we're fine. That works out. Okay. But yeah, this game probably could have benefited from having like a background install on PS3. I don't know if the 360 version loads any quicker. But yeah, this version, oof. Takes its sweet time, it does. What if I could land to the stunt there? I'm getting a little bit more graceful with this, but barely. Like, I'm still struggling. Nailed it. I did good. Oh, it's a five lapper here. We got another trophy. Three whole fucking trophies. No way. Oh my god. Okay. Why'd I try that? That was bad. That was dumb. I am so sorry, Mr. Snowmobile. Why do I keep trying to call it a ski-mobile? Mr. Snowmobiler, I am failing you. I am in dead last place again. Due to my recklessness. This is tough. Because you just spin out so easy. Like the back of, look at that. Like you just freaking just, oh my god. I lose like all control of the back of the vehicle so fast. I don't know how people do it. Like anyone's good at this game, like played this game a lot. I don't know how you do it. I want to learn. Because holy crap. Okay, so I should have a boost here, which I will use here. No, I don't have it maxed. So I think I gotta do a little bit more for the adrenaline. I am still super last place. Boost ready. Goddamn right. I'm still like half a lap behind them. We're going on the last one. This was definitely a lot cleaner than the first race, though, even though I am without a doubt way further behind than the first race, which is odd, because I feel like I did a lot better with my driving here. But whatever. Even got the stunts going well. I'm stuck. Oh, because that was the end. Okay. Let's do another race. Let's do one more. Let's go to like Norway or something. Get out of Canada. Maybe Canada's just a curse. The Canadian curse, you know? Those game's really cool. It controls weird. Like, it controls really freaking weird. Like, it just feels like the back of it's, like, just always on ice. It's, I don't know. Well, Norway's, like, all straightaways. Oof. Maybe not Norway. You know what? This US one, it's very basic oval. Let's go for that. Okay. Front flips and back flips get me the most. we wait. Come on, USA. Bring me the gold. Give me what I need. Give me what I want, what I really, really want. I don't know why Spice Girls came to mind. Look, half tired. But blame everything right now on me being tired. Me failing, I'm tired. Me spinning out, tired. Spice Girls, tired. Perfect scapegoat. Loading screens long? Fuck it. We'll blame it on me being tired too. Anything else we can blame on being tired? I don't know. This video inevitably being claimed by YouTube and like various other copyright holders because of the music in the background? Me being tired. Should have turned that off. But screw it. That's a four lapper here. I will say what this game does like really well right now is the sense of speed I'm getting. I'm getting a very, very nice sense of speed. Like, very nice sense of speed out of it. Because even though I'm, like, maxing out at, like, 80 miles an hour here, it feels like I'm going lightning fast, like, up to these corners. So, like, nailed that. Because sometimes, like, you'll get a racing game, and, like, you'll say, like, you're going, like, 100. You're like, okay, I barely feel like I'm moving. This one, I feel like I'm hauling ass. Especially for, like, the speed that I'm apparently going here. So, you know, like, good job to them on that. That's good. There is a compliment. I couldn't get the trick done. The trick system's very awkward. That's not happening. I tried. You know, you gotta appreciate the balls on me for trying that. Feeling really scrappy there. It was like, I can do this. And I'm paying the punishment for it. Correct myself a little bit. If I did this track first, I'd have been a lot happier, I think, with the game. Just so I get, like, used to the speeds and, like, how things feel here. And then I would have, like, just killed myself, like, mentally. Figuratively. There we go. When I try, like, an actual tough course. I did it! Give me that boost! Where's my trophy for that? Hey, I knew there'd be a trophy for that. Wonder if there's one for the front flip. I gotta try the front flip this lap to finish it off. Really bring it all home. Because this game seems to be like trophy candy. Okay. Front flip! Yes! Nailed it! I did good. There we go, another trophy. There's so many, like, free trophies in this. Am I gonna get, like, a trophy for getting first place for the first time? No? I'm surprised. Cool. I think, like, three races is good, though. Let's see if if there's anything going on with the servers, and I kind of want to check the trophy situation. Because this seems just give them out. I already got four. That was my phone, by the way. Picked up for half a second, just freaking dropped it. Because I'm a very careful person, obviously. There's no way this is still up, right? It is! Dude, the servers are actually still up? The servers are still up! That's brilliant! I was not expecting that. Holy crap! I was like, nah, it's a joke. I mean, it's not GameSpy. There's no way anyone's paying for these servers still, though. No. They're still up. There's the authentication's still there, I guess. I know, like, obviously this game's, like, peer-to-peer because you host it, but I would assume there'd be, like, an authentication that would be down by now, but I guess not. And I was looking at these trophies. How free are they? I'm not, like, really a trophy hunter on PlayStation, though. I don't really care. But I see, like, some games just have them pop up non-stop, and I'm like, cool. How easy is this game for these? But once this loads up, you'll see, like, I don't really go for many trophies. I'll beat the game, and then I don't really go beyond that. Like, a lot of these games I completed, and I maybe have half, if that, 20%. only platinum I have is for NCIS. Like, what a pedigree. Take down one opponent, take down three in a row, take down four in a row. Perform a two-stun combo, three-stun combos, adrenaline for 30 seconds, 60 seconds. Half of the collectibles, all. Collect 50,000, or like 500,000. Hold a stun for 4 seconds, stay airborne for five. Win with your sled intact, perform a double backflip, double front flip. Collide with three trees in a race. Collide with spectators, 20,000 stunt points in a single online match. You can probably just trick a friend somehow if you can get them to buy this. Invite someone to a race and lead a race from start to finish. That's all really easy. You just have to find someone to do online with you, but this seems like it would be like, if you're like a trophy hunter, like this is an easy-ass platinum. You just have to find someone to play with you while the servers are still up for now. Okay. But we're going to call it on Ski-Doo here. What do I think of it? Just from, like, 20 minutes of playing, obviously 20 minutes isn't, like, a lot of time to, like, really establish anything. I think, it's a cool idea. I do think the controls are a little bit jacked up, like, it doesn't feel quite right to me. Something seems inherently off with it. It's not that it's, like, a hard racing game, nor is it, like, an easy one. It's just that it doesn't feel like it responds the way it should at the moment. But that could also be down to the Ski-Mobile I'm using. Ski-Mobile. Snowmobile I am using here. Maybe the better ones can control a lot better. I don't know. Would I keep playing this? Probably not. It's a cool little gimmick idea, and I thought it was cool to check out. I don't think this is a racing game I'll want to commit like any of my own personal time to, just from the three races I did. But I think it's cool, you know? I think it has a right to exist, obviously. I think it's all right. Just the basic racing, like, if I was into the controls of it, I'd be cool with it. How does career look? Or is it going to give me, like, cutscenes? Or is it just, like, here's a few races, do them? I don't know, but, like, it's cool. Oh, yeah, it's one of these bare basic things. It's basic. Enter Garage, Dress Rider, Progress. Go to a race. Certain races are unlocked. The rest are all locked, so I guess you just gotta do them all one by one. Okay. Basic stuff. Okay. But yeah, again, that's a Ski-Doo Snowmobile Challenge. It's alright. I don't think it's worth, like, I think this game costs, like, 20 bucks on eBay still. Like, it wasn't the cheapest game, so I'm gonna assume it was probably, like, a very low print run. What's it going for right now? 20 bucks? 25 bucks? Yeah, it's about 25, maybe, like, 15 loose, by the looks of it, like, on, an eBay. It's alright. I wouldn't really recommend it for that price, but if you could find it, like, dirt cheap, like, 5-10 bucks, maybe it's worth a look at. It's not terrible. It's a cool idea. But we're gonna call it there. Thank you all for watching. I'm gonna try and go to sleep again. Y'all have a lovely day, and toodles.